高压水柱直冲向抗议人群，催泪弹瓦斯在大街上蔓延，民众甚至蹲下，忍着刺痛和难受，也坚持为陷入70年来最严重的金融危机发出怒吼。但警方依旧以强硬方式驱离人群，扫压政乱。大喊反政府口号，抗议者把街头挤得水泄不通，强烈要求政府下台，怒斥当局处理经济危机的政策失误，导致民不聊生，全国面临粮食、燃料和药品的严重短缺，学校被迫停课，石油耗尽，民众只能以脚踏车通勤。
ඉන්ධන ලබා ගන්න විදියක් ඇත්තෙම නෑ ඉන්ධන ලබා ගන්න දවස් 3-4ක්වත් පොලිමේ සිටිය යුතුයි ඉතින් මට ඒක කරන්න බෑ හැමදාම වැඩට යන කෙනෙක් හැටියට මම හිතුවා මම බයිසිකලේ වැඩට යනකොට තමයි සුදුසුම දේ。
然而，斯里兰卡在经济崩盘之际，总理威克瑞米辛赫因为选举承诺降税，反而使财政雪上加霜，导致这个发展中国家宣布破产，加剧了人民困苦惨况。
Now, Vikramasinghe had promised that they'd wrap up talks with the IMF in June. Then he promised this would happen in July. Now, this has been pushed to August. And meanwhile, this crisis on ground is just getting worse by the day.
与国际货币基金组织 IMF 的会谈并无太大进展，不仅因为需要提交重建计划，谈判遭推辞，也因为巨额的外债让对方打退堂鼓。
They're going to present a series of fresh documentation, actually fresh guarantees to the IMF, and if those get approved, then we're likely to see, you know, a certain amount of money flowing in from the IMF before the year is out. But whatever said and done, I mean, it's $51 billion. That's the overall external debt that Sri Lanka has accumulated.
斯里兰卡破产恐怕将延续到明年，预计可能等2024年经济才会渐渐好转。记者陈立新报道。
我们要告诉大家，我们有优惠，我们中天的网友哦，这些东西都可以在我们快点购网站上头来购买。现在有3种不同的好康组合，购买的时候呢，不要忘记我们有非常多的这个折扣代码可以给大家来输入，可以享有一些优惠好康。